is Asha and welcome back to Ramadan in my kitchen. So for today, we'll be making a simple smoothie bowl recipe. I'll take you through the ingredients right away. So first thing you need is actually half a cup of coconut water. So coconut water is great because after a whole day of fasting, you want something that cools your body down, especially with the weather nowadays being so unpredictable. So you want to pour it into your food processor. The next ingredient you would need would be one large banana, which you freeze in the freezer beforehand. So you can do this like a day beforehand or even a week. So I frequently make smoothie bowls. What I like to do is to store it in a Ziploc bag like this. I know it looks very mushy and, you know, doesn't look pretty. The bananas have brown. This is because it has already been exposed and these are very overripe bananas. But don't worry, it won't affect the taste. You can still use it. So you wanna pop it in about approximately one banana. So I chop my banana into quarters, so I would know exactly what would make one banana. So if you like to store your bananas like this, what you can do is actually also label it so that you would remember into how many pieces you've cut one banana. So the next ingredient you would need would be frozen kiwi. So you need approximately two kiwis. So you just want to pop that in. So kiwis are really enriched with vitamin C. And again, when we're fasting, we also want to make sure that we keep our body healthy and our immunity strong, especially as well throughout this period. Next thing you need are pineapples. These pineapples are also frozen as well beforehand. So you can see how this is so easy to prepare. You just freeze and pack them accordingly inside the freezer, and when you're ready, like a few minutes before it's time to break your fast, just pop it in the food processor, blend it, and it's ready to be served. So pineapple, and I love having pineapples in smoothie bowls because pineapples are rich in enzymes. So these enzymes actually help to aid digestion. So you know how we're so used to breaking our fast with very starchy and spicy foods? No. Once or twice, it's okay, but doing it every day does take a toll on the stomach. And of course, by the time it's like Isha after, you know, after all those yummy food, you do start to feel a bit lethargic when it comes to doing your ibadah. So what I like about this smoothie bowl recipe especially is that even though it's light, it's very filling and it's also nutritious. So it's definitely a win-win. So you want to pop that in. That's about half a cup of pineapples. And here's my surprise ingredient today. So this is especially for those who cannot eat vegetables but want to try and incorporate vegetables in their diet. And or for example, if you're a parent who's trying to get your child to eat vegetables, children love colorful food, and smoothie bowls are a good way to get those nutrients, those vitamins inside your child's diet. So this is actually spinach. So baby spinach inside. Okay, I use organic spinach, but it's up to you. Because this spinach is not cooked. This baby spinach is not the same as the Chinese spinach. You can find baby spinach in the salad section when you go to your supermarket. Next thing you want to do is add chia seeds. So chia seeds are actually they're really tiny seeds, but they're chock full of omega-3 fatty acids, which is always great to have in your diet. That's about one tablespoon, okay, one tablespoon of chia seeds. I like to also add ginger in this recipe because ginger is a good anti-inflammatory ingredient that helps fight diseases in your body. That's one. And it also adds in a bit of hint of spice, a bit of excitement, I feel, in your smoothie bowl. The taste is very subtle, but you still feel the sweetness of the ginger, just a tinge of it. And lastly, you would need honey. So about half a teaspoon of honey. You don't have to add this if you don't want to, but I just like things a little sweet. So you want to add that in. I forgot to add, it'd be good to also just stand by your coconut water, just so in case when you blend, you realize like your smoothie bowl is too rich or too thick, I'm sorry, if it's too thick, you can actually add some. Alright, once that's put in, you're ready to blend. Smoothie bowl is ready, and now all you need to do is pour it in a bowl and decorate it.